Hello, everyone. Hi, Facebook. I'm just here getting ready to go on Instagram as well. I don't think it's working for me, but that's okay. Who's here? How you doing? I didn't realize I was already on here for 10 seconds. How funny. All right, Instagram. Now I'll just take a break for today. How are you doing? Okay, so welcome to Tuesdays with Terry. So today, still talking about confidence because I'm launching the Confident CEO, Clearly Confident CEO 12-week program on Thursday, on June 10th. So I'm super excited about that. So I want to continue the topic of confidence because when I was doing my target market research interviews, the biggest thing I got was people were lacking confidence. And then when I was asking them, what I've taught them about, a lot of times it was how to be confident. So yeah, let's keep on talking about confidence for a couple more days, because this is just an amazing topic to really go after what you want, get what you want, goal achieve, have a disciplined mind, having the willpower. There's just so much power in confidence when you can really know yourself, trust yourself, ask for what you want. So those were what we talked about the last couple days. Also making sure you have a powerful circle around you that's going to lift you up, not caring what people think. Because their opinion of you really doesn't matter. And you can care about the people, but you don't have to take on their beliefs and their opinions of what's possible for you. So that was the first couple of days of my little confidence series. And today I want to talk about confidence being a state of feeling the fear, but doing it anyways. So even when I go live on live stream, I still get like, oh man, like, are people gonna be interested? Are they gonna like what I have to say? And it's like you just do it anyways because my mission that I have and the goals that I want to achieve are bigger than maybe whatever could happen on this live stream, which when you really think about it, like really what's the worst that could happen? Maybe I could fumble over my words, maybe someone wouldn't like it, but really not, it's not that big of a deal. So a lot of times we're making things bigger than they even need to be. So just go ahead and do it. And then another thing I learned was Mel Robbins has the 5 second rule. So you're not like counting to five, but you're counting down like a rocket. So it's like 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then you just go. So then you hit live and you're live. And so it's happening. And so she did this when she was super depressed and you're just having addictions. She would just like, because your brain, I guess, has 5 seconds to make that decision. So you just go ahead and do the right thing, or the right thing, no right things, but the thing that's going to lead you closer to your goal. Okay, so feeling the fear and doing it anyways. Many of you know that I study A Course in Miracles, which I absolutely love. I'm in my second iteration of the workbook lessons now. It's so amazing. So, in A Course in Miracles, in lesson 48, it actually says, let his strength take the place of your weakness. So, I mean, God has no image, but, just for sake of, like just, making things just oneness. So hit let his strength. So when you can really, really, really lean on God, then there's nothing to fear. And so I've been really vibrating with the state of having no fears. Yes, it's like it's a daily, like working on it. But man, the more I give in to not being like fearful, the more I can just, so when you accomplish these goals, you don't accomplish the little tasks that you want to do, you feel more confident anyways. But not having to feel like I have to do this all by myself, or like it needs to be my strength that's gonna, muster up the courage to do whatever I need to do. I'm leaning on God, like God walk me through this, let me be led. And that really, it's just been bringing the most beautiful people into my life. The most beautiful blessings have been happening. I've been able to serve in such a bigger way. And it's just, yeah, it's just been so amazing. So I just really want to encourage you today. If there's something that you feel fearful about, you can still feel the fears and then do it anyways. So I encourage you actually to lean into your fears. Whatever feels fearful to you, do that. So there's this thing, I've been listening to a lot of like Neville Goddard lately and Florence Scovel Shinn on YouTube. I would definitely look them up. They're really old. They're from like 1950s. But these like are like, just timeless teachings. They're so good. So I've been listening to it and saying you're, when the lion, when you come up to a lion, I mean, I wouldn't try this, but the lion gets its ferocity or fierceness from your fear, and so it's like if you can just walk up to that lion, like it's not, it's like when you run, it's gonna chase after you. Anyways, I thought it was a really fascinating concept that was by Florence Govoshin, so good. Let me know whoever's tuning in. I would love to know who's popping in here. All right, so that was basically it. I'm trying to make these under 10 minutes so you can just digest them real easy. But let me know what you've done to feel the fear and do it anyways. I heard of moms that, they're not like any kind of, strong woman competitors or anything, but when their child was underneath a truck, like a t I don't even know how many ton truck, they could lift up the car. And so recently my cat was on the roof crying. She must have just got on the tree, jumped on the roof, and got stuck. And so the ladder I have isn't even big enough to get on the roof. But the thing is, my cat's crying and scared to get off the roof. So I probably had like, I don't know, 4 or 5 feet in between the where the ladder ends and my roof. But I'm just like, I'm gonna go do this. She needs my help. So you just feel the fear, do it anyways. And something, be safe, but in many cases, feel the fear and do it anyways when you're like goal achieving, going after what you want. So I got her, and then I'm balancing, trying to get back on the ladder, and she's freaking out with the height, so she's trying to get back on the roof. So it was like a crazy situation, but I was like, man, this is how you do it. You feel the fear, do it anyways, and when you have like a bigger mission, bigger than you, then you're gonna go and make it happen. And then one of my friends, Satori, he actually has a book. I think it's like Unstoppable or Unshakable or something. A really good book, but one of the things that he does in his chapter says, write down like 150 things that you know how to do, and that's gonna boost your confidence. So you're gonna be like, oh yeah, even if it's just like, oh, tying my shoe, like, driving a car, riding a bike, because you can always do those things. So it's like you do it, things like I am, I have achieved. So it's just building up confidence, and that at the end of that 150 things, like you're gonna feel really, really good. And there's also like the power poses you can do, like when you want to step into your most confident self. So that was the tips I wanted to say today, and I would love to get your input on how you stay confident, or how you get confident, or if you're confident, if you want more confidence. I'd love to make this a dialogue, not just a show. Hi everyone, I love it seeing everybody here. So yeah, feel the fear, go through the fear, do it anyways, and go achieve your dreams. Anything's possible. Don't let fear get in the way, because really, in truth, there's absolutely nothing to fear. Fear is an illusion. It is false evidence appearing real. So you can either choose faith or you can choose fear. Both of them are unseen. So I would say go with faith. Doubt your greatness. How about that? Instead of doubting, like, oh, can I be successful? Doubt, like, who am I not to be successful, right? All right, well, I hope you're having a great day. I know it's a little bit later today. It was super busy, super productive, amazing day. All right, well, have a great one. Take care.